Spencer Hawes after the exciting 125-121 unfortunate Vandals win. Give us a little bit about the game. You guys are down 25 at one point, and then you just kind of kept pounding away. You know, what was going into talking to him on his back in there?
Yeah, you know, we just had a slow start, but once we got going, you know, turned it up a little bit on defense, better things started happening for us. Unfortunately, we were able to.
Yeah. So, talking about your NBA career, you know, 2 years ago, you guys were in the playoffs. You know, kind of got to the second round, really surprised a lot of people. Next year, had a little bit of a roster turnover, and then more roster turnover this following year. What's it like going from that transition?
It's tough, but you know, that's the new NBA now. I mean, it's like the bargaining agreement, that's how it's gonna be. You know, the days of having a guy be on a team his whole career, you know, other than maybe one or two guys, those days are over. So there's gonna be a lot more turnover. It's just something that you have to be ready with. And in today's day and age, you know, if you're not getting it done 1 year, chances are they're gonna move on. So you know, going forward, you just have to be prepared as individuals to come in and do everything you can.
So talk about this Nerlens Noel trade. Young guy, highly talented, male, perfect for the same thing that he was predicted. Have you got a chance to talk to him?
I haven't got a chance, but I'm looking forward to it, and I'm looking forward to kind of having the opportunity to show another young guy the ropes. It doesn't seem like too long ago. Brad Miller coming in and really helping out, and now to be on the flip side of it, I'm really looking forward to take a little bit of that leadership.
How do you feel about you and him meshing?
I think we complement each other. You know, he's very athletic, shot blocker, great around the rim, and I think we'll be able to play off each other once he comes back healthy.
And there's a proposed coaching decision on the table. I don't know how much.
Hey, how you doing?
I don't know much about that. You know,
everybody goes that way.
So whatever happens, happens.
We're going west of the building.
Appreciate it,
Spencer.
Right.
Thank you. We're now closing it down.
Yep.
So we have Will Conroy. Will, give us an idea of what happened in that game. You guys were up, had a pretty big lead, and then they kind of came back, fighting back, and you guys held them off for the win. But kind of walk us through what happened there.
Well, when you get up in program games like this, you kind of get relaxed, and then you just start throwing the ball all over the gym and not really caring, taking any other guy's shots. And then they got hot, and then big fellas started walking us down. Spencer Hall started walking us down. We couldn't stop him. We was too small for him, and we was too big for him. He just kept going. And then the refs start going with them. The crowd wanted to start seeing them win, but we pulled it out.
Sounds good. So you with Minnesota for some time last year, had some success there. What's going on next in your career? What's the push for you for Will Conroy?
Well, I don't know. We're talking to a couple of NBA teams. Let's talk to some European teams. We'll see. I thought about going into player development coaching. Boston Celtics had called me before they had hired the new coach, but he ended up bringing up all his staff from Butler. So they went ahead and took those guys from Butler. So we'll see what happens next. You know, I'm just enjoying working guys out and doing the run around here, trying to lead our young guys the right way.
We appreciate that. And is that what your next step is player development, or are you in the coaching side?
When I finish, you know, Coach Romar told me keep playing until you can't play no more. So when I'm finished, I'm definitely going into coaching. I like to see young guys do the right things. I've always naturally been a leader, so I think it's just natural for me to slide right into that position.
So you've been here since the Jamal Crawford League has started. Mm-hmm. You know, give us what you've seen there and what you see right now and the changes that have really the publicity that has now gotten. How does that feel, you kind of having a front row seat to
it? I think it's grown tremendously. It's because of everybody. It's because of guys like you guys like Ball of Life. Everybody's contributed to making this one of the most powerful summer leagues in basketball across the country. So we got a lot of good talent here. I think we're like per capita, we're like second or third in the NBA players.
First.
See, so we're putting players in the NBA. We got almost an NBA player on every roster. I mean, we had two, well, we just played against, I think, Micah Downs had a call-up last year, but he got hurt. He was going to Boston, but it's Terrence Williams, another Seattle product. So, I mean, we got a lot of players here, so the league is growing, and many pros we put it in, we just going right here in the pro.
We appreciate it. Will Conroy.
Pleasure. Appreciate it. Good job.